guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Meghna and today I'm going to be swatching the part 2 as in the remaining shades of the MyGlam LIT Matte Liquid Lipsticks. So the lipsticks that I'm going to be swatching today are a couple of nudes, browns and plums and berry shades. So without any further ado, let's just begin with the swatches. This first shade is LM78 Holmes, as in Sherlock Holmes. So this is a very nice nudie terracotta shade, a really pretty. I actually quite like it. I was not supposed to buy this. I bought it on a whim because they had buy one get one offer and the total in my cart was coming to be like an odd number, so I just bought this because I wanted to make it an even number, and I'm so glad that I did. Very pretty, very extremely pretty, a daily wear, office wear kind of a shade. If you are dusky skin tone, go for this shade without any, you know, doubts in your mind. Very pretty. You can see how stunning that looks. So yeah, this was the shade LM78 Holds. This is the shade LM79 Realness, and this is more like a warm terracotta shade. I wish I could describe these colors, you know, like you can see the difference between Holds and Realness over here. This one is Holds. This is more pinky toned sort of, and this one is more like a warm rusty sort of subtle red, but it looks good on me. It will look good on all skin tones. Again, this could also be like an office wear kind of a shade for dusky skin tones. On lighter skin tones, I feel it's going to look dark, so it's not going to look as subtle, but on me it looks really pretty. I have no problems with this. I have no issues. Only thing is that it's a bit on warmer side, which I do not like because it makes my teeth look yellow. So yeah, that's the only thing, but otherwise it's a very pretty shade. So this was the shade LM79 Realness. This next shade is called LM80 and it's called Zaddy. This again, I don't know how to explain these shades. I mean, there's only like very slight bit of difference between these shades, so it's like really difficult for me. But this is more like an orangey, like a rust orangey sort of shade with a bit of pink undertone is how I would describe this shade. It looks pretty on me. It'll look pretty on all skin tones. Also, it's warm toned. It's not neutral or it's not, you know, cool toned. It's quite warm toned, but yeah, it will look good. You can say that it's like a corally shade but with a bit of pink undertone to it, and I don't really know what else to say about this shade. So yeah, this is the shade LM80 Zaddy. This shade is called LM82 Respect. Okay, Respect. And this is a rusty brown shade, like a rusty orangey brown shade. As I'm swatching these lipsticks right one by one, it just keeps getting warmer and warmer. If you can see, it just keeps getting warmer, like, you know, moving towards orange and less towards pink. So yeah, about this shade, I think obviously this shade is going to suit all skin tones. It's very rustic, rusty, orangey, brownish shade, as I already said. Apart from that, I have nothing else to say. So yeah, this is the shade LM82 Respect. This shade is called LM83 So Fetch, and this is like a maroon shade with warm brown undertone. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. It looks like it has a warm brown undertone on me. I think on fair skin tones, it might look like a deep red. I'm not really sure, but a maroon with warm brown undertone is what it looks like on me. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. So yeah, this was the shade LM83 So Fetch. This shade is called LM84 OK Boomer, and this is like a chocolate brown shade, a warm chocolate brown shade. It looks good on me. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. If you're looking for a warm chocolate brown, then this is a good shade. So yeah, this was the shade LM84 OK Boomer. This next shade is called LM85 Dark Academia, and this is a deep dark chocolate, again a deep dark chocolate, but this one has more like, you know, olive undertones, if you know what I mean. Like, this one was straight up dark chocolate, like a warm dark chocolate sort of shade, and this one has I don't know if you can see the camera, but this one, the Dark Academia one, has more like, you know, olive undertones to it. It is really pretty. It is going to be very flattering for especially dusky skin tones with olive undertones. I do have olive undertone, and it looks really nice on me, like even better than the previous shade that I had swatched. So if you're looking for a dark chocolate sort of shade, then this looks really, really, really pretty, very vampy. On dark skin tones, it won't look as vampy, but I think on medium or even fair skin tones, it's going to look very, very, very vampy, sort of a dark brown shade, but a very pretty brown nevertheless. So yeah, this was the shade LM85 Dark Academia. This is the shade LM89 Voguing, and this is a very nice purple berry shade. It is really pretty. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. These are the kind of, you know, berry plum shades that I like. It's very cool toned, it's not warm toned, very cool toned, very pretty, very purpley berry plum shade. Alright, so yeah, this was the shade LM89 Voguing. Next up, the shade is called LM90 Insta Baddie, and this is a very nice pink berry shade. This kind of shades make me very happy. It has, I think, a bit of red undertone. So it is a very neutral shade, it's not warm or cool toned, I think. But yeah, very pretty, obviously going to suit all skin tones. So yeah, this was the shade LM90 Insta Baddie. This next shade is called LM91 Dank, and this is such a pretty pink dark plum berry sort of shade. It's really nice, it's quite vampy. I think on lighter skin tones, this is going to look like a really nice vampy shade, whereas on dusky skin tones, even deeper skin tones, this looks so pretty. These type of shades tend to look really gorgeous on, you know, the deeper duskier skin tones. I really love this shade. I'm in love with this shade. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. It is cool toned, nothing warm about this shade. Absolutely love this shade. Only thing I will say, the shade in particular was a bit patchy to apply. I had to put on a little bit more efforts in order to get like an even coat, but apart from that, it is such a beautiful shade. You can see for yourself. Also, I feel this shade is quite unique because I don't really have anything in this shade. It's really, really, really pretty. So yeah, this was the shade LM91 Dank. Next up, the shade is LM92 Hits Different, and this is a very pretty, you can see how pretty it is. It's such a pretty purple shade. It's a deep purple. Obviously, it's going to suit all skin tones. Excuse my application over here. I was trying to apply it properly and I lost control and I let it be. So yeah, this shade obviously is going to suit all skin tones. It's a very extremely pretty shade. I personally love this shade. Really, really, really pretty. It's sort of like a purpley magenta shade, but more on the purple side. It has this kind of like brightness, so it's like a dark purple, but it has like magenta kind of brightness. It looks really pretty, extremely pretty, obviously going to suit all skin tones. So yeah, this was the shade LM92 Hits Different. Next up, this shade is LM94 A Drip, and this is a very, 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 very deep dark purple. It's deeper than this one, which had like a bit of magenta tone to it. So this one is like really, really proper true purple, but like a very deep purple. It reminds me of like, you know, those dark purple velvet fabrics. It kind of reminds me of that. Like if I had to wear like a nice deep purple velvet gown or something, I would definitely wear this lipstick with it. It looks very nice. It is definitely a vampy shade. It's very dark, but it will obviously suit all skin tones. So yeah, this was the shade LM94 Drip. This last shade is called LM95 E-Boy, and this is a deep dark purple, like a purpley red sort of shade. It does have, I feel, like a bit of red undertone to it. Very dark, very vampy, I would say. Obviously it's going to suit all skin tones. The shade was a bit tricky to go on. I had to, you know, put in a lot more efforts than compared to, you know, the other shades, but it is the same formula. It feels the same on my lips, but really dark. None of these darker shades stain. But yeah, if you're looking for like a dark vampy shade within 500, then this one is like really pretty. Be sure to check this one out. So yeah, this was the last shade, that is LM95 E-Boy. Alright, so that was it for the rest of the 13 swatches, you guys. My review about these lipsticks is already there in the part 1. And if you have not watched the part 1 of the video, then I will link it in the description box. Be sure to check that one out as well. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. I upload a video once every week. So do click on the notification bell to get notified of all my future uploads. If you liked watching this video, then be sure to like, click on the like button and share it with your friends and family who you think might be interested in these lipstick swatch videos, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.